Hi, I'm Sharon Macklis at IDG Communications, here with Do More with R, Keep Your Passwords and Tokens Secure with Keyring. As a former security reporter, it makes me a little queasy to store a password or token in plain text. And that's basically what happens when you store a password or token string in an R environment variable. The good news is that if you use R environment variables, they don't show up in your environment tab. And if you share your code with someone or post it on GitHub, you won't reveal your credentials by mistake. Here's an example. I stored a fake Google Client ID and secret in my R environment. If I use them with the Google Auth R package, they don't show up in my environment tab when I set options. Here I want options. The bad news is that they're stored in a plain text file, .renviron. We can see that if I open the file with the use this package. And there they are. A better idea is using the keyring package. Install it from CRAN with the usual install.packages, then load it with library. You can store a value in keyring from R with the key_set function. See what happens when I run that to set my fake client ID. I can set the value once interactively, and I never have to type the value in clear text. Same for my fake secret. Now the best way to use those values is as an argument within a function. That way, the actual values never show up in your environment tab or history. I can access the values with keyring's key_get function. You can see key_get is an argument within options. And I can check with options to see that the value is actually set. I would never actually run this in real life, but here I can see my fake ID value showed up. Keep in mind, this still isn't super secure. It's a big improvement that your credentials are stored in an encrypted keyring. But anyone who can access your machine and knows about the keyring package can still get to your credentials. keyring_list will show all the available entries in the keyring, although not the values. To add a layer of security, you can create a keyring that's password protected within R. Do that with keyring_create. I'll create a new R credentials keyring, and I'll be asked for a password. You can unlock the keyring at the start of your session with keyring_unlock. And here I'll enter my new password. Now you can set a value for a new token specifying the new keyring. And you can get a value the same way as before, but again specifying the keyring. You can lock the keyring at the end of your script with keyring_lock. Now, if you or anyone else run key_get, you or they will be asked for the keyring password. And you've got some more security for your passwords and tokens in R. That's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. For more R tips, head to the Do More with R page at https://go.infoworld.com/morewithr, all lowercase except for the R. You can also find the Do More with R playlist on YouTube. Hope to see you next episode.